Hey guys, welcome to SS Unitech, Sushil this side, and today we are going to see the overview of the Azure Data Factory. In the last video, we have seen about the introduction of Azure Data Factory. So here we'll be going to discuss few basic concepts. Those are very important if you are going to start working with the Azure Data Factory. So let's get started. So what is pipeline? So a pipeline is a logical grouping of the activities. So what is the activity? First, try to understand about the activity, then we'll be going to see the pipeline. So what is the activity? So a activity in a pipeline defines the action to perform on your data. So what action you want to perform on your data, that is the activity. And it could be inside the pipeline. So for example, if you want to move the data from your SQL Server to Azure Blob Storage, so you can use the copy activity. So this is one of the activity by which we can move the data from any source to any destination. And this is very similar to the control flow task inside the SSIS. So now try to understand about the pipeline. So as pipeline is a logical grouping of the activities that perform a unit of work. So together the activities in the pipeline perform a task. For example, a pipeline can contain a group of activities that ingest data from Azure Blob and then run a Hive query or HD inside cluster to partition the data. And this is very similar to the packages inside the SSIS. So as inside the SSIS, we can create the package and where we can create the control flow and the data flow, so we can move the data. So inside the pipelines, we can do the same thing. Next is the data set. So what is the data set? So data set identify the data within the linked data stores. So what is the linked data stores? We'll be going to see later in this video. So here we can understand data set identify the data, which is the linked data store, such as SQL table, files, folders, or any documents. So for example, an Azure storage linked service links a storage account to the data factory. So on that case, an Azure blob datasets represent the blob contains and the folder that contains the input blob to be processed. So we can directly say data sets are very similar to the connection managers inside the SSIS. So if you talk about the data sets, then we can simply understand this is a type of the connection manager by which we can keep the information of the source and destinations. Next is the linked services. So what is the linked service? So linked service, as you can see here, linked service are very similar to the connection string inside the SSIS. So inside the connection string, it will be going to keep the information of your source and destinations, how we can connect with that. So in the linked service, it is the same thing. So here you can see the link service are very much like the connection strings, which define the connection information needed for the service to connect to the external resources. Those could be the source or destination. Think of this way, the data set represents the structure of the data within the linked data stores, and link service defines the connection of the data stores. So data set will be going to store the actual data by the help of the linked service. So linked service is needed to create the connection, just like a connection string. And after that, data set will be going to keep the data with the help of the linked service. So thank you so much for watching this video. I hope you have the clear idea about the data sets, linked service, pipelines, and activities. In the next video, we will be going to do the practical demo on the Azure Data Factory. See you in the next video.